Since I turned off the game system between parts, I have to walk back to where I was before, so I should probably show this cutscene off. Yeah, since I got the water into this room, I filled up the water just a little bit higher. Now I'll see you back at the other room. And now I can officially say, yee, hello everyone, and welcome back to the walkthrough. Let's see what's in this room. Oh, I don't like this room. This is probably the only room in the dungeon that I don't like, simply because it confuses me. It's not a puzzle room, it's like a maze room, and you'll see as I go through this thing. Like, you'll see there's multiple layers to this thing, and I always get lost at where I am going, and that's kind of a problem, but I don't really blame the room per se so much as myself, just because I can't seem to figure it out. Obviously, I'm aiming to get to that treasure chest over there, but I always forget how to get to it, and that's kind of a problem. This is definitely not the path, at least I don't think. I think you're supposed to surface somewhere and go across land, then dive down again, like maybe surface here. And let's look around. No, wait, that's back at the beginning. I can walk across here. Well, I could. Actually, I'm unsure. Let's just go back in the water, I suppose. Back up. My control stick wasn't functioning again for some reason. I was holding back, but it wasn't pulling back. Whatever. Yeah, there's definitely a way around this room, and as I said, I turned off the game system, so it's gonna tell me the rupee values again. At least for the special ones. What if I go through here? I don't think I went through here. This looks new. Kind of. Is there anything through here? No. I really hope none of these walls I have to blow up, otherwise I'll be very, very sad. I hope I'm not going back to the beginning. It certainly feels like I am. Can I climb? Yeah, I did go back to the beginning. Dang it! Maybe I was supposed to, like, claw shot over to something, but I didn't see anything that warranted a claw shot. Like, no, there was no vines or anything like that, it was just straight shot. Okay, so I'm gonna go through here. Now I'm going to get electrocuted. And I'm going to, yeah, this is a dead end. This, wait, is this? Oh, how did I miss that? That's bombable. Definitely don't need the lantern. I think I can just plop it down. Hello, bombfish! These things explode, and will explode if they're caught in other explosions. You can pick them up like bombs if you were to use your claw shot on them. And yeah. But anyway, let's just go through here and actually make some progress. Wait, what's... Oh, this looks like it's gonna be the path to the treasure chest. Don't hit me. Please don't hit me. I'm begging you. Don't touch. I'm germophobic. I can't open this door while I'm swimming. Okay, that actually kind of makes sense. And I'm gonna go surface. Oh, jeez. Oh my. Oh, goodness. How do I get to that, per se? I can kill off the fish if I wanted to. But that doesn't seem... I don't think I'm supposed to drop on it from above. Like, I could just do that to... Oh, I thought that would kill the fish. Maybe I have to shoot him with the arrows. But... No, that doesn't work. Oh, I'm so sad. It's probably something in the water that I'm missing. Like, can I possibly bomb the center pillar down or something? Probably not. Don't bite me. I just want to look around the room. I'm not harming anyone. You don't have to do anything rash. Alright, back on the platform. I guess if you get him on land, you can kill him off like that. And you could probably just kill him underwater by putting the iron boots on and fending them off. Maybe I'm supposed to kill off these critters. That's the key to this room, per se. Well, let's try it. Why not? Can I do... Yeah, I can do spin attacks underwater. That's pretty helpful. One at a time, though, if at all possible. Jump attacks are way too slow. So do not do jump attacks. I really don't know. Hold on, I'm gonna see. Any target up there? I really feel like I'm supposed to be dropping down on that thing from above or something. I always get so confused with these rooms. I'm gonna leave because I just don't see. You see, there's a hole leading to that room from above. That's what makes me suspect that this is a return room of sorts. Because I can't grab onto anything and nothing happened when I killed the fish, so I'm just going to deduce that is what I'm supposed to do. I'm gonna surface here and see where that gets me. This treasure chest. Come on. That's not bad. But it's not exactly what I'm looking for. There's this. Wait, really? No jingle? Come on! I did that for nothing. Well, I'm sure it entertained somebody, so I suppose it wasn't for nothing. What's over here? This might be the thing that I'm looking for. Uh-oh. They're so easy! Well, now that I have the claw shot. Alright, so there's that thing in the way. Dang you! Anything on the... Ah, okay. That makes more sense. And I could just lower myself down just to be safe to make sure I don't, like, automatically roll or something. There we go. And this will give me the boss key! Well, big key. But still, that's basically what it does. Lets you in to fight the boss. And I'm pretty much done with the dungeon, aside from a few stray treasure chests. Let's take a look at the map here. Like, you'll see there's those two there. There's the one in the middle of the room. And then there's that one down, up the left route. I'll see you over there, at the next location of where I can... Well, here I am back at the main room, so I could do that treasure chest way, way up at the chandelier first. I was expecting there to be there's vines here. You can use these to swap around the room now that you have the, claw shot because of the way that it can latch onto things across borders, and this gives you loads upon loads of shortcuts through the dungeon. Alright, so I want to get to the upper level. There we go. And now I think I can latch onto it from here. Yes, I can. And this gives you, as said earlier, a heart piece. Woohoo! Next treasure chest! Alright, back over here. You remember this water slide? Vandalia 1998 told me that you can actually go back up these using the iron boots, so I guess I can collect this treasure chest now. Woohoo! But in case you don't realize, this is going to take me a little while to get up there unless I use these things for the most part. But yeah, so I'm gonna cut until I get back up there. Ugh. That was not pleasant. It took forever. Anyway, I'm going to climb up here. Wait, actually, is that? Yeah, it's not going. No, wait, I can get it from up here. Okay, I just don't want to slide down there again by mistake or something, because that took a very, very long time. Alright, so let's open the chest. And that was not worth it! But I suppose it is worth it for 100%ing the dungeon. Alright, as long as I'm up here, just to make sure I didn't miss anything there. Okay. So back down we go. Whee! Alright, remember this room? The one that I got stuck on down there because I just couldn't figure out that I needed to look up at the ceiling to shoot some stuff? Yeah, this one. What you want to do is go back through this passage and redirect the water flow to come through here. The reason why that is so you can fill up that water and then, I mean, fill up the basin with water and then stuff in that area will float. I have all the water flow going here, so everything is in tip-top shape, 100% efficiency. So it's no big deal changing the water flow anymore, because you don't have to worry about the stairway puzzle, since you can just use the claw shot to go around the whole area. And look at that, the bridge floats! And that's exactly what you need to get over to that other side. Now I can just flop myself in the water, or walk on land, one of the two. Go across here. Hey, wait, what? Oh. Oh, okay. I remember this now. Woo! Yeah, you gotta get through there before it closes. And you can only... And it takes a little while to close. So that's why you have to use the claw shot to get through here before it closes. You can't run to... get there before it closes. You have to use the claw shot. Anyway, open this, and you get another heart piece! Woo! Now let's get out of here. Using this, and are you gonna get in my way? Spin! Yeah! That was pro. Well, sort of. I took a little damage. Now, I see there's another one on that chest there. I mean, on the map there. Oops. Do I get through there from the first floor? It sure seems like it. I must have missed that when I went through that path before. Yeah. Good thing I had the compass. And that's why I like the compass so much. And is there anything to grab onto up there? Fine, I'll just... do it the old-fashioned way, I suppose. Get up here! Climb up! So slow! So very slow. I could actually use that, but whatever. Guess that would have given me a ample shortcut. Right, ride this around, I suppose. Until I get to that room. Is there anything I could have used to get across there? It doesn't look like it. I mean, a little bit faster. Just that I don't like to waste too much time when I'm cutting over from place to place. For obvious reasons, of course. Alright, now that I'm in here, There's some water that I can dive in, and... Oh, is this area that I missed the chest? What a shame. So, it's through here, right? I missed the little alcove. So sad. But I got water bombs for my troubles of going back here. Now, is that it? Is that really it for this dungeon? Sure looks like it. Alright, back to the main room we go. See, this dungeon isn't bad at all, I told you. Anyway, now what I'm going to do is get myself to the center area, because I can now swim over to the boss room, and I might... No! I didn't mean to do that, but I can still get here in time. And now that I can get to the boss room, let's do it! It's like, why not, right? It kind of seems silly to just put the boss in another part, you know? So here we are. It's dark. It's spooky. Just dive down. All the way to the bottom. I don't know if swimming or putting on the iron boots is going to be faster, but I'm going to want to put on the iron boots to start with, actually, for this boss fight. So I think I'll just plop them on here. And look at the tentacle over there. Do I want to get close to that now? I'm not sure. I probably do to get the fight started. Yeah, there we go. Didn't quite remember how it started. Does this look familiar? Ocarina of Time players? My, this is Morph Eel. It's like a combination of Morpha and an eel, you know, Morpha from Ocarina of Time, and its weakness, at least in the first phase, is pretty much the same. Just try and Z-target that eye as it goes through the tentacles, and let's see what Midna has to say about this. Well, thanks for the hint, but I knew what to do. Do not get too close, or you will regret it. The tentacles will pull you in, and that will suck. But what you want to do is grab it, yes, and attack it as many times as you possibly can. And here come the bombfish. Not good, not good. I'm going to try to target one of them, or just aim for the eye. It doesn't really matter, but I can throw a bombfish into its mouth, if I'm not mistaken, and stun it for a bit. Although the bombfish would get in the way no matter what I'm doing. Whoa, actually, this works nicely. Oh, see, that's what I mean about the bombfish, is that they kind of get in the way of things, and yeah. Ah, wait, oh, never mind. Well, that's too bad, but that's okay, I'll try it again. Have to try it again. Oh, that worked out well. I was gonna say try and get it away from, so it doesn't swim back over to Morph Eel itself, if at all possible, but eh. I think I'll be okay this way. I wonder if manually targeting it or Z-targeting it would be better in some cases, because just the way how it squirms around, it doesn't seem like it. Z-targeting does seem to be the way to go. Oh, that's it for phase one already? Well, okay. And it is revealed to be a massive beast. Probably one of the largest bosses in Zelda history. Now the eye is up there. Unequip the iron boots and start swimming! No, really. That's what you're supposed to do. Don't get in front of its mouth. That's a problem. It'll suck you in. Now, Get above it. Keep your claw shot out. See, target it. Yeah, this is how it's done, baby! Attack! 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 Yeah, just Z-target the eye. And when you get latched onto it, swing the sword like crazy. Where's the eye now? I need to get ahead of it. There we go. Yeah! It's a rather easy boss, but dang, is it ever epic! And you'll notice it shakes you off after a little bit, but don't worry about that. You swim almost as fast as it, so it's like no big deal even getting back onto it. Yeah! And on those tentacles, pretty much worthless at this point for it. And that's the fight. I also like how it destroys pillars around the area as well as it goes. Another neat touch. It just shows its power. I've been doing that the entire walkthrough! You know, slamming my face into walls when I do roll attacks. Strangely, despite being underneath the sea, the water drains out of the room. I don't get that myself. Maybe there's another air pocket under this dungeon. And its eyeball turns into a hard container. That doesn't seem very healthy. Well, it's not its eyeball anymore. It's where its eyeball once was, its eye socket. And there's the last few shadow. Oh ho! Well, it's no biggie, I suppose. Yes, we shall. But first, let's grab the heart container. I think I'm going to leave this area in the next part. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you then.